Good morning. Today we are going to learn about vectors and scalars. Here we go.
Hey guys.
Hey Bob.
Hi Bob.
Flippin' physics.
As an introduction to vectors and scalars, I want to walk through a rather simple example. In order to do so, I need something that moves at a rather slow constant velocity. And I actually had a really hard time finding something that would do this. So I made one. I made a race car. I made slow velocity racers.
Really?
Now we need to know how fast slow velocity racer moves. So I had her race right next to a meter stick. Remind me, Billy, how long is a meter stick?
1 meter?
Yep. Somehow people sometimes forget that a meter stick is 1 meter long, which is also 1,000 millimeters. And you can see that slow velocity racer takes 23.8 seconds to travel 1,000 millimeters. So we can use the equation speed equals distance over time to figure out the magnitude of her velocity. Now we can substitute in 1,000 millimeters for her distance traveled and the time it took her to travel that distance, which was 23.8 seconds. And what do we get for the speed of our race car?
42.0168 or 42.0 millimeters per second.
Actually, for the purposes of today's examples, we're just going to use two significant digits. So now we know that slow velocity racer can move at approximately 42 millimeters per second. We could put slow velocity racer on the track on the top that is moving at 42 millimeters per second to the left, or we could put her on the track on the bottom that is moving at 42 millimeters per second to the right. Considering slow velocity racer wants to move as quickly as possible, Bobby, on which track should she race?
In order to move as quickly as possible, she should race on the bottom track.
Yes, Bobby, and why should she choose the bottom track?
Because then she'll be moving at 84 millimeters per second.
Absolutely correct, Bobby. The speed of the car plus the speed of the track, or 42 millimeters per second, plus 42 millimeters per second is equal to 84 millimeters per second. In other words, if slow velocity racer races on the bottom track, she will be moving at 84 millimeters per second. Bo, how fast will she be moving if she races between the two tracks?
42 millimeters per second.
Correct, Bo. The speed of the race car plus the speed of the track, or 42 millimeters per second plus zero, is equal to 42 millimeters per second. In other words, she'll just be moving at 42 millimeters per second if she races between the two tracks. And Billy, how fast will she be moving if she races on the top track?
Well, she actually wouldn't end up moving.
Correct. In that case, we get her total speed by subtracting the speed of the track from the speed of the race car. In other words, 42 millimeters per second minus 42 millimeters per second, which is equal to zero. So if she races on the top track, she actually isn't moving at all. And I do recommend that everybody try this at some point on an escalator or moving walkway. It is quite fun. Here instinctively is called tip-to-tail vector addition. It's also sometimes called tail-to-tip vector addition, but it's the same thing. So we have a representative vector right here, and you can see this is the tail of the vector, and this is the tip of the vector. So for our bottom track, we have both objects, the track and the race car, were moving to the right, so both vectors are going to be drawn to the right. And you can see we've placed the tip of one vector on the tail of the other vector, and the net vector, or the resultant vector, is twice as long, or 84 millimeters per second. For the top track, the track itself was moving to the left, so we have the vector representation for the track moving to the left. The arrow goes to the left, but the race car was moving to the right, therefore that vector is going to be to the right. and you can see we put the tip of one vector on the tail of the other vector, and these two end up canceling one another out completely. Therefore, the net speed for the top track of Slow Velocity Racer is equal to zero. That is the basic concept of tip-to-tail vector addition, and we're going to spend more time talking about that in our next lesson.
You know, that's actually pretty obvious.
That is exactly my point, Bo. Vector addition is, at its root level, quite simple and something you probably already inherently know how to do. I will, of course, in the future, make it more difficult and confusing. However, please remember that it is based off of this intuitive concept.
Why would you want to make it more difficult?
And confusing?
Because that's his job.
Yeah, well, we do have to make progress in this class. So, let's define vectors. A vector is a quantity having both magnitude and direction. Bo, remind me, what is the definition of magnitude?
It's like the stuff.
What?
The stuff and the quantity.
That's not helpful.
It's like the amount of the quantity.
That doesn't really help me either.
Okay, you know what? We'll come back to that question. I think let's do this first. I think it'll help. A scalar is a quantity that has magnitude only. It does not have direction. And we've actually already in this class been working with vectors and scalars, that we just haven't identified these variables as vectors or scalars yet. And I think if we do so now, it'll actually help us to define the term magnitude. So class, let's start with vectors. Could you please give me some examples of variables that are vectors?
Displacement, velocity,
acceleration,
force,
torque,
momentum.
Yes, displacement, velocity, acceleration are all vectors that we've worked with, and force, torque, and momentum are actually vectors we haven't yet worked with, but we will. And now, could I please have some variables that are scalars?
Distance.
Speed.
Time.
Volume.
Density, and money.
Money?
Yeah, distance, speed, time, volume, density, and money. Those are all scalars. As far as money, think of it this way. Does $5 east make any sense?
No.
Then money is a scalar. Basically, anything where adding direction doesn't make sense is a scalar. For example, the number of hairs on my head. The number of beads in this box. The number of markers in my hands. The number of pieces of plastic in this Hoberman sphere. The number of crayons in this box. The number of pages in this book written by my cousin. The number of pentagons on this ball. The number of feathers in this bag. The number of swords my daughter owns. The number of air molecules in this ball. The number of peanuts I can get to land in my mouth.
I think we get it.
Good, let's get back to this term magnitude. And let's use displacement as an example to help us define magnitude. If you recall from a previous lesson, if I start right here, and I end right here, my displacement is approximately 2 meters east. What then is the magnitude of my displacement? Bo?
Oh, it's just 2 meters without the direction.
Correct.
So it is the amount of the quantity.
Pretty much, Bobby. The magnitude is the numerical amount of the quantity. And the velocity of Slow Velocity Racer itself was 42 millimeters per second east. Therefore, Billy, what was the magnitude of the velocity of our race car?
Ah, the magnitude of the velocity is just the numerical amount of the velocity without the direction. So just 42 millimeters per second.
Yes. Now, be aware that scalars can be negative. Initially, some people think that scalars can't be negative. However, please realize that scalars can be negative. An example to prove my point, we already know money is a scalar. Therefore, can you have negative money?
Absolutely. Bo owes me the $2 he borrowed from me in third grade because he wanted to buy a ring for Barbie because he thought it would impress her.
He was wrong.
I can't believe you guys can remember that.
That's good.
So yes, Bo has negative money. Quick review. Tip to tail vector addition is something that you probably already inherently know how to do. We illustrated that using the slow velocity racer. A vector is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. A scalar is a quantity that has magnitude only and does not have direction. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Oh, wait.
One landed in my shirt, too.